and Bill2014. Mr. Ho, thank you. Now, in accordance with Rule 55.1A of the Rules of Procedure, I move a motion to pass the bill now being discussed to a select committee. That is Copyright Amendment Bill 2014. You have 15 minutes to speak, Ms. Sitho. Thank you, Mr. President. From the first week onwards, this debate on the Copyright Amendment Bill has clarified matters. However, as we spend more time in exchange for government officials and the Copyright Alliance to come out and explain to us more clearly, at the same time, we also understand that they have disseminated misleading messages to the public. And we understand that this legislative year will end in July this year, and there are 18 bills in the waiting list, waiting to be tabled in this council for resumption of second reading. The PAN Democrats would like to see these bills being, the second reading of these bills being resumed. But at the same time, we must also safeguard the free flow of information and freedom of expression. They must not be stifled by the copyright bill. That is why, in accordance with 55.1A of the Rules of Procedure, the proceedings would be referred to a select committee so that we can further debate on the key issues of the bill. So that the select committee can submit a report to the council. Meanwhile, as the select committee does its work, the council will be available to deal with the 18 bills outstanding. First of all, this would offer a buffer for dealing with the controversies arising from this Copyright Amendment Bill. And second of all, it will also maintain smooth operation of this council. So I have also tried to lobby the support of the loyalists. Well, the loyalists is the majority of this council, and you are in control of the time and pace of this select committee. So, and at the same time, this council will be available for dealing with other motions. Now, if we want to talk about the history of this bill, we should not start with 2006 as Ms. Starry Lee did. We should instead turn to when the original ordinance was enacted in the 1990s. Mr. Gary Fan, call for quorum, Mr. President.
設係點解嗰個？
Mr. Tall, please continue. Thank you, Mr. President. In 1997, when the primary legislation was enacted, it regulated physical copies. But now, what we are trying to include is intangible copies. So for this amendment bill, if it were proposed 20 years ago, it would have been passed. But now, even a member of the public who is in his 60s or 70s is using a mobile phone and disseminating copyrighted materials and who may be breaking the law any time of the day. The pandemocrats will act as a gatekeeper to make sure that this bill will not be passed. Now, the secretary talks a lot about the numerous exceptions in the bill. But on the other hand, we need to consider the restrictions or limitation of this bill, restricting the freedom of speech and flow of information. Because everybody with a mobile phone will be affected as far as their day-to-day activities are concerned, such that whenever they go online and share information, they may risk breaking the law. So the pandemocrats are trying to play the delaying tactic by invoking Rule 55(1)(a) of the Rules of Procedure to set up a select committee for examining the bill. The purpose of the select committee will be to invite the relevant parties to come forward and provide more information. In fact, over the past 2 months, more information had indeed floated. Well, for example, yesterday, Mr. Chen Qixun asked an oral question involving the copyright issues over the chief executive singing the karaoke song Loving You. And in the second part of the administration's reply, I quote, whether the person using the copyrighted material incurs any liability would depend on whether the copyright owner pursues the matter. This is outrageous because it is a principle of the law that there should be clarity and certainty, so that the public understands which act will be criminally liable. I mean, first of all, we need to be clear what acts would incur criminal liability. It cannot be as outrageous as what you said in the reply yesterday.
You said whether or not that person has liability would depend on whether the copyright owner would pursue the case. How come this will become part of the law? Why can't you be clear what is criminalized and what is not? The bill now is very clear. This will be criminalized, but the administration is asking the copy owners not to sue you. Customs and Excise will not sue you, and the copyright owners say they cannot find the evidence, so there is no way the case will be won. However, you still have to go to court. You still would be regarded as having committed an offense. How come there is this law that would criminalize people's daily activities, and then you say we can depend on the mercy of commercial organizations not to pursue the case? Yesterday, the oral question goes to show that the CE has committed an offense because he hasn't been able to locate all the people who hold hold the copyright. And if some copyright owners say, I don't want your money, I want to take you to court, now they can choose to do that. And the CE is still owing royalties. And an average citizen is not backed by the entire bureau, the entire information services department, and the entire Department of Justice to help him do this. And we cannot make use of the Legislative Council as a platform to show the public that we have tried our best to comply with the law. The average citizen doesn't have such rights and privileges. After the bill is passed, we would only be able to depend on the mercy of you and the copyright owners. Such a law cannot be passed. And I also need to clarify something. Pro-establishment members, including Mr. Lo Wai Kok and also Ms. Sito, please wait. I call for a quorum count, please, President. Ms. Sito, thank you, President. I'd like to add one word first with regard to the reply to the oral question yesterday. The Secretary actually said that whether there will be liability will depend on whether the copyright owner will pursue the case. So you are actually telling us that it is very easy to break the law. Pro-establishment members, since the Secretary has told you that there is a trap, why do you want to push the public into this trap? Talking about the exemptions or exceptions, the pro-establishment camp and the Secretary say there are 60 odd exceptions, but only three are to accept individuals. I am so angered after listening to you. Therefore, I comb through the entire bill again. 35B, it is about parallel import. It is about the business. 38.3, fair dealing, again, the business sector. 38.2, library. 40B, reading material for the disabled, and charges are applicable. And then 41A, educational organizations, not individuals. 46, library. 54B, LegCo. 54, legislature. 55, criminal procedures or litigation. And then 58, public records. Again, these belong to the administration. Do you want me to go on? Ms. Sito, you should now address why you want to commit the bill to a select committee. Yes, President, I understand. Committing the bill to the select committee will give us more room for maneuver, so we are not limited by the 15-minute speaking time, so we can clarify point by point so the public can understand that the administration's messages are misleading. You say there are 60-odd clauses that provide exceptions, but then there are only three that provide exceptions to the individuals. Please allow me to say something about this because the select committee might not come to pass. I hope pro-establishment members can support the motion. 79, a home video recording of films, and also 80, a home videotaping TV series, and 81A, listening to the news in the car. These are the only exceptions for individuals. And also, we are talking about freedom of speech and transmitting messages on the internet. And the three exceptions for individuals just cannot compare with what we are pursuing today. So how can you say with wide open eyes, Secretary, that there are 60-odd clauses providing exceptions? Because these are not protecting the individual. Actually, we will be constructive, Mr. President. We are going to move very constructive amendments, and these would have to be discussed by the select committee to be formed under 551A. I'd like to thank Professor Peter Yu because he really knows the contents of overseas copyright laws, and this is what he proposed to us. And the copyright owners say they will not take action against netizens, but then they can if they want to. And the Copyright Alliance has been more frank. They say that the signing of contracts, and they actually place emphasis only on such contracts with business organizations. So actually, we can separate the interests of netizens and the network providers. We don't know the laws of overseas countries. We thank Professor Peter Yu for coming back at Christmas to give the information to us. But Mr. Secretary, you have so many people collecting information for you, and yet you were not frank in coming forward with such overseas examples. The proposal is that we can include a civil criminal sanction in the law, and that is to prohibit criminal prosecution to be taken out and civil action to be taken out against non-profit-making individual activities on the net. This prohibition can certainly stop copyright owners from taking action when there is non-profit-making copyright use. You don't have to say this is legal. We are just talking about the stopping of litigation against an individual's non-profit-making activity. If this is clear in the law, if this can protect the individual, then we can agree to list infringements as offenses. Mr. To, I still don't understand why you are saying this, because this does not seem to have a relationship with committing the bill to the Select Committee. President, this is related. This is a new viewpoint. At the Bills Committee, we did not raise this viewpoint. But now there is this viewpoint. We hope to have a forum to raise it for discussion, and that will be the Select Committee. So we can shorten the distance between the two parties because we can propose such an amendment. If different political parties and affiliations can discuss issues and not get personal, then we can all have an in-depth discussion on new information and new angles. I have to raise this here because I want to lobby members. At the bill's scrutiny stage, no one advanced that viewpoint. Therefore, I hope members will understand that if there will be such an amendment, then the Select Committee will be able to draft that amendment and put it in a report and let it come back to the Council. And if it is endorsed by the Council, then according to the rules of procedure, the bill can go directly into third reading and there will be no loss of time or waste of time at the Council level. Thank you, President.
Ms. Sitho has moved that the Copyright Amendment Bill 2014 be committed to a committee of the whole Council. In accordance with our ROP, I will have to first deal with this motion. And I'll put a question to you that the Copyright Amendment Bill 2014 be committed to a committee of the Council. May I remind members that we have already passed the second reading of the bill. When we debate on Ms. Sitho's motion, we should not repeat the arguments already advanced in the second reading debate. So we are debating on whether this bill should be committed to a select committee or whether we should proceed to the committee stage. Members should express their views on this different treatment. For views that should be reserved to the select committee or the CSA or to the committee stage, they should not be expressed at this stage. Can I first invite the Secretary for Commerce and Economic Development to speak? President, call for quorum, please. Secretary, please wait.
商務及經
Secretary for Commerce and Economic Development. President, in response to Ms. Ho's, before I respond to Ms. Ho's motion to for committal of the bill to a select committee, I'd like to thank members who have voted for the bill to pass a second reading. I think we have moved an important step forward when it comes to further protection for copyrights. I'm very disappointed with Ms. Ho's motion. Same as the adjournment motion Ms. Ho moved earlier, it is not really helpful for the timely passage of the bill because our copyright protection regime is already very outdated. If we do not act in a timely manner, we will be further behind our competitors, not to mention overtaking them. We can't even be on par with them. I appeal to members to oppose the motion so that we can move on to the committee stage of the bill ASAP. Thank you.
Ms. Helena Wong. Mr. President, I speak in support of Ms. Sidho's motion according to 55.1A, which is a motion to give the bill to commit the bill to a select committee. Although, with the protection offered by the pro establishment, the bill has passed through the second reading stage. Do they participate in the debate? Some pro-establishment members have put on their headphones. They just block their ears and they just Mr. Wong Kok-hing. The member's motion is irrelevant. I am listening. I think Ms. Wong is explaining why she supports the motion. Ms. Wong, please go on. Thank you, Mr. President. The pro-establishment should, councillors, if they are responsible, then they should listen clearly why there are so much voices against the bill. They should try to listen why the pan-democrats adopt a quorum count approach to block the, and delay the passage of the bill. You just close your ears, you plug your ears, and then you just vote for the bill. This approach of dealing with the bill is irresponsible. Therefore, it is necessary to commit the bill to a select committee. Whether it's according to the speeches of the pro-establishment or according to the behavior of the pro-establishment members, and also according to the speech of Greg So, we are not convinced. We are not assured of the effectiveness of the bill. Ms. Wong, you should spell out. The differences between committing the bill to a select committee and vis-a-vis giving the bill to the committee stage. Now, according to the ROP, you can, Chairman, you can, Mr. President, you can appoint a starting date for our commencement day for the work of the select committee. The select committee will hold open meetings unless the chairman directs that the meetings are to be held in private. Therefore, members can specifically put their minds to consider why this bill has got into so much controversy. Now, the select committee, this provision is seldom invoked. I mean, the ROP, this ROP has been seldom, has been rarely invoked. Members are fighting, members are doing filibustering because the bill doesn't just deal with the rights of the copyright owners. The bill also affects millions of people who are using Facebook, who are using YouTube, who are using their smartphones every day, and therefore the bill affects millions of people every day. If we just hastily pass a bill, we will be unable to bear the consequences. Now, Ms. Wong, now if this bill is not passed, the bill will not be committed to a select committee, but it doesn't mean that the bill will be passed. We will go into the committee stage. If you support this special motion, then you have to explain why this bill should be committed to a select committee instead of being handled by the committee stage of the whole council. Otherwise, what you say will be irrelevant. Mr. President, I understand what you mean. I've already explained that this bill is very important and it has far-reaching impacts. The second reason, Mr. Gary Fan, well, please make a quorum count. Point of order. Can members stay away from their seats? Would members return to their seats?
黃碧雲議員。
Ms. Alina Wong. Mr. Deputy, I just now explained why I support Ms. Sitho's motion to commit this controversial copyright amendment bill to a select committee, because the bill has a far-reaching or has far-reaching impacts. The second point I made is that there are many controversies, outstanding controversies in the bill. The Secretary is not able to address the worries and concerns of members and netizens, and our proposed amendments are not able to convince the Secretary and also the pro-establishment members. It is a stalemate. If you continue the process, there will be three CSAs, and each will deal with very technical issues. And if this is allowed to go on, then it will require a lot of time. It will be until longer than March, and we still have this big document, which we can go through with you page by page. Do you want all of us to go through it? Because we are all suffering, and you suffer more because you need to make a quorum, but you are not listening. You just put on your earplugs. If you want to continue the process, you are going nowhere. And even Mrs. Carrie Lam has made a slip of tongue. So instead of going it this way, please withdraw this bill. Committing the bill to a select committee will enable this council to move on. Because of this bill, it is causing a blockage, and the bill cannot balance the interests of the copyright holders and the netizens who make use of the products to do secondary creation. You say the prosecution threshold is very high, but what is high and what is low is subjective. If you continue to wear on this, there are a lot of bills going on, for example, the Columbarium Bill and also other bills. Do we want to block all those bills? Now, after the policy address, there will be the motion of thanks debate, and then after that, there will be the budget. And then there will be debate on the budget, a motion debate on the budget, and we need to pay the civil servants. And will the appropriation bill have enough time to be dealt with? You have to think about the consequence. I thank Ms. Sitho for moving the motion so that there is a way out in view of facing this present stalemate. We don't want to abort this bill, which has been discussed for a very long time. We don't want the secretary to withdraw it, but if you insist on moving on, then it is getting nowhere. This is just like a patient which is very weak. It can hardly stand. It's about to fall. Instead of getting into a stalemate, instead of getting into the quagmire. There will be the problem of the appropriation bill. The budget will be shelved, and the civil servants have to be paid. And that will also be bad for the pro-establishment, because you have to sit there every day. Headcounts will remain. The ask for quorum will continue unless there is a consensus. The six members of the Democratic Party supports Ms. Ho's motion. She has proposed a way out. We have found a way. We want to find a way that can satisfy the copyright holders while the netizens can continue their activities in cyberspace without being threatened by prosecutions. Ms. Helena Wong, you are now repeating your argument. Please move on to a new argument. I'm saying that we should send this seriously ill patient to the ICU. Mr. Gary Fan, please, a quorum count.
黃碧雲議員
Ms. Helena Wong, Mr. Deputy, just now I said that I support Ms. Sitho's motion. If we can commit this controversial bill, I said I support Ms. Sitho's motion to commit this controversial copyright amendment bill to a select committee. I've already explained the argument in respect of traffic congestion, the so-called traffic congestion theory. I hope that the pro-establishment members will consider this as a way out under the present stalemate. If we continue with the present arrangement, you'll hear the bells sounding again and again. You will have to continue to bring along your earphones and also electric charger. You cannot stand very long. You are standing in the way of everything because there are many bills. Is it important? You are repeating yourself, Ms. Wong. Mr. Deputy, I want to say that the merit of committing the bill to a select committee is that it's just like a patient. We should send a patient to ICU. Now, if you repeat, I'll ask you to sit down. Mr. Deputy, just now I went to Taiwan to watch the presidential election. Tsai Ing-wen repeated many times. She said that there is just 1 mile to go with the rise of new power and also the change of political party. This is just like this bill. There is just 1 more mile to go. If you continue to push, it may just be pushed into a precipice. At the end of the day, you may have to withdraw the bill. We really want the bill to be successfully amended so that we can have a way forward. Now we are at the brink of a cliff, and we cannot go on. If you force your way, then you just drop into the cliff. You just drop down the cliff. A responsible approach is to stop, and then don't stand in the way of other bills. This controversial bill should be committed to a select committee so that a way out can be found. The pan-democrats asked for 3 amendments, UGC, contract override, and also personal use. If you say all three, among all three, what can be acceptable? Instead of just counting the quorum, please put it to the select committee so that we can iron out the differences, so that we can complete the extra mile. Ms. Sitho's motion is a solution to the present stalemate, so that we can continue and we can walk an extra mile and find a solution. The members of the Democratic Party support committing this controversial bill to a select committee. Though the Secretary claims that the bill has addressed part of the or some of the concerns of the netizens by providing 6 exemptions, they are just like 6 types of raincoats. If the rain is small, maybe when you put on the raincoats, you can stand the rain. But when there is a heavy downpour, that will be different. Can there be a big umbrella so that the rights of the copyright owners can be upheld and the concerns of the netizens can be also addressed? They want a big umbrella so that they can be protected. They will not be inadvertently caught by the trapped by the law. The amendments are reasonable. The academic issues have been addressed by numerous experts. When the pro-establishment members go into the committee stage, they should look at this. They should read this document instead of closing your eyes, press the button, and support the bill. The community has to bear all the consequences.
Ms. Claudia Mo.
Support of the proposal to have a new select committee to deal with this copyright amendment bill. Previously, we had Mrs. Regina Yip speaking in this chamber, telling everyone here that she had this very grave concern about some smear campaign, or name smear campaign, rather, against this copyright amendment bill. The fact that it has been called something like Article 23 in the Internet, or in short, Cyber 23. And according to Regina Yip, this is a name-smearing campaign, and it's just not desirable. Now, if you can't even get a name right for a bill, I think we surely need more time and room to get things clarified. Exactly why this amendment bill has got this rather undesirable name at all? How did it get started? And I perfectly agree with Mrs. Yip that Article 23 does sound rather dirty in a way, because it actually talks about treason, sedition, subversion, what have you. It's quite scary. By dirty, I actually mean scary. And why would people equate Article 23 in the Basic Law, which is yet to be legislated?
Ms. Claudia Mo, I'd like to remind you that actually the President reminded members that here you should only focus on why this bill should be committed to a select committee under ROP 551A, and you should not address other issues. Mr. Gary Fan, President, I can see that because Ms. Claudia Mo was speaking in English, they left their seats. Please, a quorum count.
毛孟靜議員
Ms. Claudia Mo.
Now please try to understand that I'm trying to give you a catalogue of areas and issues and concerns that need to be further addressed and preferably in this select committee, a new one. Beijing loyalists are all bungalows because they have only downstairs. And that's why they would just quit without wanting to listen to any of the speeches on this side. Now, my second concern here was actually prompted by Greg So in reply to Slow Beat's oral question yesterday about CY Leung posting Hello Kitty bun pictures on his Facebook account and how that could have infringed Hong Kong's copyright law. And in reply, Greg So said something like, copyright owners apparently have expressed acquiescence, to use Greg So's own wording, tacit permission to allow it. So you guys wouldn't need to worry about copyright infringement in this regard. But how could a legal question become a guessing game? Or simply to be defined by some official at his whims, as he would think so? That's very scary. Who's he to decide what copyright owners would want? So we need this particular special committee, a new one, preferably, again, involve our new IT bureau chief. What's his name again? I couldn't quite remember. Something Wei Hong, right? Nicholas? I think he should get involved, being an IT chief, the IT chief in Hong Kong. I mean, you couldn't just assume that Hello Kitty copyright holders in Hong Kong are all quite happy, are all quite generous about people just feeling so liberal using that cat's face on social media. You can't assume things under the law. That's my point number two. And point number three may be dated back longer while before Christmas, I should think. And that is when our intellectual property chief in town told some radio program that even on the surface, CY Leung might have infringed or committed some sort of offense under the copyright thingy.
毛孟靜議員，我再提提你。
Ms. Claudia Mo, I'd like to remind you again, I have already reminded you before, that you should address why the bill should be committed to a select committee and not continue with arguments for second reading debate resumption.
Previously, this is my first time ever that I mentioned all those points. And by all, there were only two, okay? 2 points.
范国威议员.
Mr. Gary Fan, I can see that President Mr. Wong Ting Kong was not paying close attention to Ms. Claudia Mo's speech. Please, a quorum count. Ms. Claudia Moore, please continue.
Allow me to continue with my list of reasons for agreeing to have this new select committee to deal with the controversy at hand. So you're perfectly aware that the whole thing has become a guessing game, almost, guessing who's going to speak for how long and about what, and a waiting game. You've been waited around. Of all people, you are the one who's been looking after this session, right? But that's beside the point. The select committee is not going to look into your plight, although you surely have my sympathy. My point number three that I was going to name is the fact that our intellectual property chief told some radio program before Christmas that because CY Leung might be classified as some celebrity, some hot shot in town, the fact that he's the chief executive, right? He might be excused for using copyrighted images or products on Facebook. Now that's a very unsettling line. It's no ordinary statement from some ordinary people. It's from our intellectual property chief, and that would need clarification in the most thorough sense to the public. So this new select committee, I don't know if you heard earlier, I was suggesting that our new IT bureau chief should be involved too. To seriously look into what's going on, how do you and where do you draw the line about copyright? Could you just assume that a copyright owner just wouldn't care or wouldn't bother? Or could we just count on the person's generosity? Or how do we define who's a celebrity? Things like that. I mean, we can talk till cows come home here. But if the government, Greg So in particular, just wouldn't bother to address questions and controversies of the sort, we'll just go on and on with this. And what's the point? What purpose does it serve? I always tell my university students, Mr. President, you were at one of my lecture sessions at Chinese University quite a few years ago, right? I always tell them, yes, indeed, and even in the modern world, we can't just throw grand-sounding lines all over the place. All men are supposed to be equal. All are born equal. Are there times when some are more equal than the others, like celebrities?
Let me remind the honourable member, you should be explaining why.
I am,
you support,
sir.
Support the motion to commit the bill to a select committee.
Well, I've been trying that. I hope you get my point.
I'm still waiting for your reasoning.
Okay, I will further elaborate, in which case, sir, I find that very offensive. That person there actually said, shut up. I find that offensive, sir.
Members, order, please.
As well.
Right.
Now, we need to talk about... Now, he wouldn't shut up. See? Could you please ask him to shut up?
Members, keep quiet.
Sir, will you dare to make one more noise?
Miss Claudia Mo.
Sitting there. See? You heard him.
Miss Claudia Mo, please do not digress.
Off. Topic, don't worry. What I'm trying to say is, in life, we always say, oh, we're all supposed to be equal. But I always tell the young, say, when we go on the MTR, if there's a vacant seat, You can't say, I'm young and full of energy, I'll just go and grab the seat. Despite the fact that there's an elderly gentleman right next to you, and you think you defeated him. And you talk about, aren't we all equal? No. We don't talk about equality. We talk about fairness in life. And celebrities are somehow...
What has all this got to do with whether we commit the bill to a select committee on?
You see, he's being offensive again. He actually said on the record, it's a bloody waste of time. Bloody is considered by many English teachers as foul language.
I'm asking what all you have said doesn't seem to me to bear any relevance to our motion. Whether we should commit the bill to a select committee. Please speak on that motion.
Yes, I am. I have been. What I'm saying is, if some top government official, when speaking on this copyright amendment bill, would actually publicly, officially make the statement that if somebody is considered a celebrity, he just might commit any offense and get away with it without consequence or with impunity. You see the point? You see? That needs very thorough clarification in the select committee.
At the committee stage, as well as in a meeting of the select committee. So it doesn't make any difference. The same point can be brought up either during the committee stage, the whole committee, or at a select committee meeting. So please distinguish between the two and explain why you believe that committing the bill to a select committee is the better way.
Now, as a select committee, we're allowed to collect evidence. Evidence. We need probably sociologists to come and define what celebrity means in a modern world, in a civilized society. Anyway, it's been 12 and a half minutes now, so I get your point. I'll go back, I'll carry on with my reason number four, and that is, sir, the whole thing has whipped up so much public furor. And you couldn't say you didn't notice it, right? So let's give ourselves just a bit more time, just a bit more room, and we'll have a more harmonious society, wouldn't we? We have this colleague called Lo Wai Kwok speaking last night, saying that he got so irritated and inconvenienced by the quorum call bell. I quite agree with him on that point. But then when he actually said he got actually terrified at the stop of the bell because he couldn't be sure whether it's actually just a quorum fulfilled or it's the meeting being aborted. Well, if he were actually sitting here, he wouldn't get that sort of traumatic experience, wouldn't he? So, why is this person not shutting up at all? He kept mumbling. He's been doing stage whisper. He would make sure that I could hear, but maybe not you. So what's the meaning of this, sir? Mr. President, this is just, I think, a very childish behavior on that person's part, don't you think?
Point of order. I think what Ms. Claudia Mo said about me was offensive. I already said I was saying that if the division bell would stop, I would have to look at the clock or else I wouldn't know whether there was a quorum. Mr. Wei Kwok, I was listening to her very carefully. Dr. Low, you might say, you might have a good reason to say that what Ms. Claudia Mo said about you was unfair, that it was not aligned with the fact, but I could not hear anything offensive. And also in this debate, Dr. Lo Wai Kwok, you can speak and you can then respond to what Ms. Claudia Mo said. This is a debate. So, members, apart from the speaking member, other members should remain silent and toe the line of the rules of procedures. Ms. Claudia Mo, please continue and complete your speech.
Any of my colleagues to speak for or against what I've been saying in the last, 12, 13 minutes, right? You're perfectly entitled to. Please do speak up instead of just sitting in your chair, mumbling, whispering like some old grumpy whatnot. Now, sir, I seriously think because in a select committee, we can collect evidence. Let's have a, I wouldn't say a fresh start, but we have a relatively new start, not a restart. A relatively new start. Thank you.
何俊仁議員.
Mr. Alberto. President. I think this is the first time in this council where we have a member invoking ROP 551 after a secondary debate for a bill to be committed to a select committee for hearing. Some may say that at this point, by committing the bill to a select committee is just for the sake of stalling or filibustering. But please listen to my arguments I'm going to advance, and you will understand that the administration has yet to provide some very critical information. And it has not investigated or looked into some very important facts. And we're asked to pass a bill based on assumptions. And we've been accused of being unreasonable and wrong by not passing the bill, leading to a lose-lose situation. Now you have to listen carefully and decide whether the administration is being fair. Why do we want the bill to be committed to a select committee? I'll just raise a few points, very simple and yet important points. Mr. Albert Ho, this is not a committee of inquiry, rather a select committee. Yes, a select committee can inquire into things. One of the most important functions of a select committee is to find out the facts and to base on the new facts unveiled to decide and debate and to give a thorough consideration of new facts. Of course, there are members here who would pass, endorse anything proposed by the government with their eyes shut. But being a responsible legislator, we have to be accountable to the community and to millions of netizens. When we understand their anxiety, how can we act in such a irresponsible manner and just pass the bill? President, when responding to a question by Mr. Chen Qichun, the administration really shocked us in part of his reply. Now, we now know for sure that CY Leung did not know that he had to seek authorization, and he was coached into seeking authorization afterwards, and then the director was teased because it was not really some commentary on public issues. So very hastily, they paid a royalty of $600 to cash seeking authorization so that they could use it for 6 months. But I read out part of the reply here, which is rather ridiculous. In reality, there is this common phenomenon. Before using copyright works or for copyright copyright works, there was no agreement, prior approval, or consensus with the copyright owner. If the common practice of this industry is such that it can objectively reflect a consensus between the user and the copyright owner, then it's an implicit consent and implied consent, and that is legally acceptable. Whether the user is legally liable would depend on whether the copyright owner would pursue, and also the ruling of the court in a litigation. I think, of course, this is very ridiculous. Of course, depends on whether people will seek, will claim. Mr. Ho, is it in any way related to the motion in question? Now, I want to say that in the whole bill, it is assumed that there is implied authorization or implicit or acquiesce, and also a normal practice in the industry. When it is a normal practice, then it is subjective and authorization. What are we talking about? Can we find where in the report of the Bills Committee we can find something similar so as to make amends for Siwa Leung? Because Siwa Leung has yet to find authorization for use of some of the works, and therefore he said that there is acquiescence. I have to interrupt you, Mr. Ho, because I don't want to digress from the subject of the motion. After all, ROP 55.1. Well, please be seated first, Mr. Ho. I will stop the timer. Now, this is the first time we have invoked ROP 55.1. Now, the bill has also passed its second reading. We have already voted on that. According to ROP 55.1, after a motion for the second reading of a bill has been agreed to, it must be committed to the whole committee unless we pass a motion for the bill to be committed to a select committee. So in front of us is what should be the next stage. Mr. Ho, you have to bear in mind that we've already voted on that motion. The second reading reading of the bill has been agreed to. And in the second reading debate, I think the issues you mentioned just now, Mr. Albert Ho, have been thoroughly debated, and some members already made these arguments. We've passed the second reading of the bill, and the bill should be passed to the committee for consideration. This is something we are very familiar with, and we have this motion from Ms. Sid Ho for the bill to be committed to a select committee. So the question before us is whether we should continue to proceed to deal with the bill in a committee stage or for the bill to be committed to a select committee. And Mr. Albert Ho, may I remind you that a select committee may not necessarily be set up for the sake of an inquiry. ROP 55.1 has made it very clear that a select committee will be set up to tackle a bill, and afterwards the chairman will submit a report to the council. And once the report is adopted, that would be tantamount to have the bill having gone through committee stage. So we have to decide whether we would follow our usual procedure, and that is for the bill to go through committee stage or for it to be committed to a select committee as proposed by Ms. Sid Ho. So in this debate, I hope members can point out the differences between the two routes, why you go for one and not the other. That would make our debate meaningful. If we repeat our criticisms of the bill, which should have been pointed out in the second reading debate, is inappropriate. If we focus on the provisions, if we say that the amendments are very complicated, well, they can be discussed at a committee stage, and therefore we should not advance the debate on the provisions and the amendments, which should be done at the committee stage. So the subject of this debate is whether we should proceed to a committee stage or for committee of the bill to the select committee, Mr. Albert Ho. That's exactly what I want to do. I want to explain to the council, including yourself, why we need a select committee. Because I just read out some very complicated issues. What is meant by acquiescence? What is meant by this implied authorization? These are very complicated legal issues. If we accept this argument without understanding it, then we will affect many people. And the select committee will have the input from experts. How can we just adopt the bill with our eyes closed? In particular, these issues have just been raised today. Now, for the rights for indigenous villagers to build small houses, we all thought that there was acquiescence for the current practice. So should we accept arguments from the administration so easily, thinking that it would be a solution? Because right from the beginning, there was no one who have advanced these arguments for discussion. It was only today that the administration talked about an implied authorization or acquiescence by the copyright owner, and the government is proposing to us, then never mind, we can pass the bill first, or you can do it first and see whether the copyright owner would claim you for the damage or whether somebody could benefit from the act. And therefore, we need to set up a select committee with input from experts, and we should benefit from experts' views. Secondly, we need the advice of experts, because this motion is a lose-lose situation. The administration claims that if we do not pass the bill, then we will just get the original copyright amendment ordinance. And there are people in the organization, in the community, who thinks that yes, with the amendments, they are better, but if we don't accept them, they'd rather not have the amendments. So it's a leave it or take it, all or nothing situation. This is undesirable. So some say that is either all or nothing. They think that they would rather not have the amendment bill passed if some of the proposed amendments are approved. 51.51b mentions people who are especially affected. I think the alliance of copyright owners should really come to explain to us once again why would they rather not have this bill. They've been telling us that without the bill there would be immense, tremendous economic loss to them. Now, the bill is about fair dealing. At least there is, at most, there is another open category of exception for the court to decide. How come? With this, they would be worse off. Yes, I think this should be left to the committee stage debate. No. We really should have a select committee to sort out everything, to sort out the pros and cons before we make a decision. Because we don't know how they arrive at the conclusion. How come somebody can so easily come out and say that they'd rather not have the amendment bill? That being the case, perhaps the bill is not as important as it seems to be. They're saying that with these amendments passed, I'd rather not have the bill. Of course, we want Hong Kong to catch up with the latest regime. We don't want people to be complained. But as far as this PC is concerned, I don't see how, why new advice could not help us to resolve the deadlock. And thirdly, there are many people who would like to pay to use a copyright work beforehand, but there is no avenue for them to do that. Now, if we add this to the bill, it would help everybody. Perhaps people would think twice. With this system, perhaps the bill is more acceptable. And I hope copyright owners can really weigh the pros and cons of the bill and also the impact on the whole industry. Mr. Gary Fan, I call for quorum. We have 36 members in this bill. We do have a quorum. Silence, please. Mr. Albert Ho, please continue. Mr. Albert Ho, order, please. Silence, please. So, are we all ready? That's why I think we need advice from experts to see whether we should have a uniformed mechanism of authorization and a unified mechanism for determining the level of royalties. Now, if people rather not take the risk, they don't want to consider whether there is any implied authorization or acquiescence for the use of a copyright work, they rather pay to use the work. But even people want to do it cannot do it now. There is no study in this mechanism. If we can have this mechanism, I'm sure it will be very helpful to for allaying the concerns of many people. Fourthly, we need a select committee because the administration has very lightly asked us to pass the bill first for a review later. However, I don't believe that this so-called undertaking can be honored. Because without 2 or 3 years of operation, we will not have enough experience for operation of the bill to review the bill. So the administration is duty-bound to explain to us whether a review is indeed feasible. We should convene a select committee to see whether a bill can really be reviewed in this manner. I think many experts would tell us that it is unlikely for a bill just enacted for 2 or 3 years and be reviewed even after there is not enough experience in its operation. This is really impossible. And Chairman, I'd like to say that when we have a select committee, we can invite scholars who are very conversant in the subject, and people are very enthusiastic to sit down together and discuss the bill. I think this is very possible. I understand that the Alliance and also representatives of netizens have been discussing with the administration very hard, hoping that they can come to a consensus acceptable to all parties. I don't believe that this is impossible. I believe the administration hasn't got everything, and Professor Peter Yu has just given us an example which can allay the concerns of many users, and that is class exception for non-profit making, non-commercial individual users. They can be exempted from criminal or even civil liability. And you have to prove that it is not a commercial use. It doesn't matter. You can put this onus on users. If the user can prove that it is not a commercial use, then you cannot start a litigation so easily. Now, if we are not knowledgeable enough, we should be humble enough to defer to the views of experts so that we can pass a bill which we all are willing to comply with in a peaceful manner, and we'll all respect the law. I hope that you will all support this motion.
Mr. Ma Fung Kwok.
Thank you, Mr. President.
There is a famous film which is a quotable quote, 3 years after 3 years, 3 years after 3 years, 10 years is coming, boss. I think this quote can reflect the current copyright amendment bill. In fact, as early as 2006, there was a consultation. In 2011, it was put before this council. In 2012, since it could not be finished before the end of the term, it was elapsed. And then in 2014, it was reintroduced, and there was endless filibustering. And now it's 2016. It has been dragged out for nearly 10 years. Ms. Ho now proposes to commit the bill to a select committee. Can that really result in rational discussion, thereby the bill can be passed before the end of this term? I have great reservation. Mr. President, if we allege that there is not adequate consultation, I cannot agree. In 2006, there was the consultation on copyright protection in the digital environment. After three rounds of consultation, the 2011 Copyright Amendment Bill was introduced. In July 2013, the administration further consulted the public on parody, and then submitted the Copyright Amendment Bill 2014. And the bill's committees there and then also organized public hearings to listen to the views of the public. Members of the public had full opportunity to express their views on the bill. Now, the Bills Committee was set up in July 2014 and ended in 2015. There were 24 meetings on the there was a public hearing in and more than 170 individuals and groups attended the meeting. More than 1,000 submissions were received. So there was full consultation and the voices were fully heard. The Bills Committee has carefully studied the bill and also had detailed discussion on the three CSAs moved by members. The Bills Committee agreed to put the bill before the Council for final decision. If we commit the bill to a select committee, that just brush aside the hard work of the Bills Committee, that's another disrespect for the Bills Committee. When Ms. Ho was speaking, Ms. Gary Fan interrupted her on two occasions by making a quorum call. Mr. Gary Fan, on the 28th of January last year, told the Bills Committee that he would withdraw, and he was the first to withdraw. And then on the 5th of May, Ms. Emily Lau also withdrew from the Bills Committee. They withdrew from the Bills Committee because, number one, either they supported the bill or they gave up their right to influence the bill. In this late stage, there are members who are doing filibustering to block the bill. Just now, Mr. Gary Fan, with regard to the motion to set up a select committee, made seven times the quorum call. When Ms. Helena Wong spoke, or before she spoke, she called for a quorum. The motion to set up a select committee was subject to filibustering. I want to ask Ms. Ho, your friend has betrayed you. How can you convince me that the select committee can discuss the bill rationally and will be able to get the bill passed before the end of this term? I really cannot see that the committee stage, which involves each and every member in this council, will not be able to discuss the bill rationally. I do not see that the committee of the whole council is worse than a select committee. Now, the legislative process of the bill has begun. From the first reading until now, we have passed 2 months. And we had discussions, and a lot of time has been wasted. Whether it is whether they are the trade and the industries, and also the netizens, they have expressed their views fully. We have passed the second reading of the bill, as said by the President. We are now in the committee stage. We are doing the committee stage to study the bill. Members can make use of this platform. This is a high-profile platform for members to give their views. I see no reason why can't we engage in a rational discussion. If we can come down and bring the concerns of the public to the forth, bring forth the concern of the public, and we can express our views without any restriction. I believe adequate information will be provided for a final decision. Mr. Gary Fan, I ask for a quorum call. Mr. Ma Fung Kwok, please continue. Mr. President, just now our colleague has made a good demonstration. I just said that the select committee, if we are to set up a select committee, it has to be first formed right from the start. Its function, its composition will have to be discussed, and members will have to be elected, and the secretariat will have to provide service, and then there will be a series of discussions, and they will have to draft a report. Who can guarantee that the effort, delays will not occur during the select committee? Who can guarantee that groups of different views will be able to reach a consensus to complete the study of the bill and get the bill passed? I see no possibility for that. The select committee, or the process of setting up a select committee, will be another way to block the passage of this bill. With these remarks, I oppose the setting up of a select committee.
The Honorable Liang Yuchong. President, I speak in support of the motion moved by Ms. Sit Ho that we should set up a select committee to deal with this bill. Mr. President, I support this approach, but I didn't really expect to do this because there is another way out which is better. Mr. President, I think you are aware of this. There was news saying that Mrs. Carrie Lam had the intention of withdrawing the bill. If she really does withdraw the bill, then it would achieve the objective of Ms. Ho. Unfortunately, we cannot see the expression of that intention or any action on the part of the administration. That's why I would support Ms. Sit Ho. Historically, the administration seldom withdraws bills while they are being scrutinized. But if there is this intention of the administration, then we would understand it. This is because other bills can then be presented to the council for endorsement. or voting. Even Ms. Sit Ho, who is proposing to set up a select committee, thinks likewise. We can again look at the contents of the bill, and we also want to complete the bill, and then other bills can then be presented to the council. I understand the rationale of Ms. Sit Ho, but unfortunately the administration did not make that move. And since that's the case, we have to set up this select committee. Why do I prefer a select committee? President, I understand that at this stage of the scrutiny, we have completed resumption of second reading debate. We should get on to the next stage. The next stage is not for debate, but for scrutinizing each proposed amendment, so people express their views and then vote on the amendments. That is the function and role of the committee stage. But in the committee stage, only members themselves can scrutinize the proposed amendments. Only members can express their views. People outside the chamber can no longer express their views. This is the biggest difference between the committee stage and a select committee. If there is a select committee, then those who support or not support or have other views can still express their views. That is the difference. Mr. Ma Fengkuo said that we should not set up a select committee because we are just going to listen to other people, and that would mean wasting members' time because we had already done our work. To a certain extent, he's right, but he is not totally right either. I heard the secretary say at second reading that he repeatedly stated a very important point. He said after the bill is passed, he will immediately review it. So I'd like to ask a question, Mr. President. Why should you get on with the review immediately after the bill is passed? If the bill is problem-free, you wouldn't need to review it. Now you are telling us beforehand that there was a review after endorsement. That goes to show that the secretary knows in his heart that the bill is problematic, or else why a review at once? If the bill is problematic, and if we rush into the committee stage, then what does it mean? Either we will go ahead without addressing the problems, or we are being irresponsible because we know that there is a problem and yet we choose not to deal with it. Now, that's a no-go. But as the administration, of course, it will say on the surface that there will be a review after the bill's endorsed. And so this is a kind of reply to some quarters that if you still have different views, we can still talk about it. There can still be other amendments. And on the other hand, it can also say that let's wait. Let's see. It can choose to do this. But then the crux of the matter is, Mr. President, is that the secretary has admitted a fact that he also thinks that the bill is problematic. If that's the case, why do we still want to rush into passing it without taking another hard look at it? Just now, Mr. Albert Ho advanced a very good viewpoint, and I wouldn't repeat him. I think we should all give second thoughts to the viewpoints he advanced. We should think about them and listen to views, tax understanding and industry practices, whatever. These are not reasonable because these are not stated in black and white, and this is not well known to the public, except for those who really pay attention and who are concerned about this matter. If that's the case,
It's true that we had already spent a lot of time and energy on the bill, but maybe we have missed out something. Maybe we did not listen to everybody with the closest attention. Therefore, if we now go into the committee stage, we are not being rational and responsible, and we do not respect the bill. As you know, the bill is very controversial. It also has far-reaching effects. Like many people say, this bill reflects our interfacing with the rest of the world. So if it is such an important bill, we should be careful in passing it instead of rushing into passing it knowing that there is a problem. This is the most important reason for setting up a select committee. Mr. President, I think you all understand, and you said it, Mr. President, just now, that the select committee is different from the committee stage. There are two main differences. One, it can take another look at the bill, and at the same time, it can invite many people, including the administration, to take another look and to express views, and to see whether there can be accommodation on the part of different parties. And in the process, the administration can do more in-depth lobbying with the two sides. This is a very important stage. As I said at the beginning, if the administration withdraws the bill, we can achieve the same effect. But it was just rumored that the administration might do it. It hasn't done it still at this moment. I don't know whether it's going to do it tomorrow. But if the administration is not going to do it, then we must set up the select committee in order to achieve the effect I mentioned. Secondly, talking about the difference between the select committee and the committee stage, it would listen, it would review, it would express views, and then it will write a report. The report will be submitted to the council for discussion and voting. By having that stage, it is not just for a few to call the shots. The select committee, of course, would be set up by a portion of members, not all members, and they will write a report. But after the report is written, it will have to be submitted to the council for debate. The report will draw a new conclusion, and then we can still comment on it and debate it. Why is that not good, Mr. President? Then we will really be expressing our function, and that is we scrutinize bills very carefully, and the bill is passed only after substantive debate. I think then we can live up to our roles and be accountable to the public. So the select committee and the committee stage are two very different things. I therefore support it because I want to achieve some effect. Lastly, Mr. President, I really cannot accept what the administration is doing, that it is pressing the council to pass the bill. As I said, the administration knows in its heart that the bill is fraught with problems, which it itself cannot solve. It is trying its best, well, quote and unquote, trying its best to arrange meetings between copyright owners and members who oppose the bill, hoping some consensus can be forged. But
Unfortunately, Mr. President, the administration has not really played the role it should. It is now acting as a go-between, but it's very late, so there is not much meaning. This is already the home stretch, and suddenly you want to put the two sides together and allow the bill to pass, but that is something impossible now, and the administration has not put forward a stance, its own stance, so the two sides can be drawn together. It is only telling either side that it cannot convince the other, and it is now playing down its own role. And the effect is that many people in the community oppose the bill, and people say the bill should not be passed. We have the pro-establishment members here. They say we must pass it because we have spoken on the bill for a long time, and if people had to express their views, they had already done so. Well, I hope we are not burying our head in the sand. I hope we understand that there are two different stances in the community. If you agree that this is the case, then the best thing is to call a halt. Let's cool down and refer the bill or commit it to a select committee. I think that will be the better way to do it. Just now, Mr. Ma Feng Kwok said, if we do this, we are just dragging our feet and Hong Kong's economic development will be affected and we cannot keep pace with the international community. Well, I beg to differ, because the select committee can achieve a breakthrough. It can include new thinking. It is not restrained by the bill as we have it. And perhaps it can interface with even more developments. So it's not bad at all. It is not too late to mend the fold after the ship is gone. Whether it is going to be something good or bad, it depends how you're going to do it. And if we can set up the select committee and allow different views to be put forward and for a report to be written and for debate, why not? Well, let's see whether you agree that there are staunchly opposing views in society and we must face up to them. We should not bury our head in the sand and dismiss the confrontation in the community. Let us commit the bill to a select committee and not force it through. Otherwise, there will be more confusion and controversy. Our society is very much torn apart already, Mr. President. If we force the bill through, there will be more division in society. I think for the sake of the community, please let us commit the bill to a select committee. With these remarks, I support the motion by Ms. Sit Ho. We will adjourn the meeting till 9 a.m. tomorrow.